In this section, we're going to be covering Boolean operations. And basically, this allows you to add multiple shapes into one shape, or using one shape to cut into another shape. So in the last section, I showed you how to add all of those triangles together as one shape. Basically, this is what this will allow us to do, plus more. So where are these? Well, they're in the toolbar just up here. You see they're all grayed out right now. So we need to select a couple of objects or shapes. I have a pink circle and a blue square. So I'm just going to select both of them. So the first one is selected. I'm going to hold shift and click the second shape. Now they're both selected, we can see they're no longer grayed out and we can play around with them. So the first one is add. And as you might imagine, it would add these shapes together. But before I click it, I just want you to take note in the layers panel, the pink circle is above the blue square. So when I click add, I want you to know that the pink circle will take on the color of the layer underneath. So I'm going to press it now, add. So there we go. They are now just one shape, one layer in the layers panel, as you can see, and also it's turned blue. So simple enough. If you were then to click on the node tool, you can see that you can further play around and customize this shape, but we're not going to do that. We're just going to press Command Z to go back. Okay, time to move on to the next one, subtract. So I will select both of them again, and I'll go up to subtract. I'll click on that. So basically, the circle has acted like a cookie cutter into the square underneath. So looking at these icons, anything that is blue remains, anything that is gray disappears. So let's move on to the next one. So I'll press Command Z to go back. They're both selected. Let's use intersect. So I'm going to click on this intersect. And you see, just like the image here, the blue one remains, the gray has gone. Command Z to go back. Let's try Exor. Okay, let's go up to Exor. And I click on that, and basically it's done the opposite of what we previously did on intersect, and there is nothing left in the middle. Again, we'll press Command Z to go back and try divide. You can see where this is going, right? So it's just going to divide all of these into three different shapes, as it shows there. So up there, I'm going to click on divide, and we can see that actually the colors of the circle remain, and so does the square. But if we pull it apart, so I'll click on this, that's one layer, that's two, and that's three. So basically, this has cut into the shape based on where the outline was. So I'll just demonstrate that by pressing Command Z to go back, and it's back into its original form. Okay, so if we head on up to wireframe view mode, just up here, click on that. If we zoom in, we can see where these outlines intersect. And basically, this is where it is cutting, and it's leaving those three individual shapes left. Okay, let's uncheck that. Okay, this next one is merge curves, and the icon isn't exactly clear what this does, but imagine if you have two objects here, they're two different layers, and you want them to just remain on the same layer. You want to merge these curves, so select both of them, go up to merge curves, click on that, and now you see, although it's taken on the color of the blue, they are now acting like one individual item. But this is more handy to use when you are drawing with a pen tool. And I know we're going to go into that later, but I'll just demonstrate quickly. So I'm going to grab the pen tool and I'm just going to create a few lines here. Okay, so let me go give it a stroke and increase that stroke a little bit. Okay, so we've got one. I'm just going to use power duplicate here just to show you. Okay, so we have 1, 2, 3, 4 layers here. And what if I just wanted them to act as one? Well, I'd select all of them, all of these individual curves, and click on merge curves. Now they just act as one. If I head into the node tool, click on that, you can still see I can play around with them individually, but I can just move them with the move tool, easy like that. Okay, moving on.